It merely tried to propagate the interest of a small group concerning the Tao, and as a result of this, we were originally on the straight path, but the Ethereum Foundation has insisted on taking a crooked path. So that was the first opportunity. The fact, our first advantage is that we have the moral high ground. Now, what is the second advantage? Second advantage is decentralization. You see, I was discussing with people at lunch. Merely focus on the development of features. But we also need to care about safety. If we travel too fast and focus just on development, we did not think about the security implications, the kind of attacks that would be done against our coding systems. So Homestead, for example, came out during March. But Homestead was a success on the whole because it was a technical fork, not a private fork. We can see how fast that Ethereum has before one feature is stable, the other feature runs out the door. So this has a great link to a system that's not going to use the currency. So those that are conservative, like ETC, because ETC is a decentralized system. It's not a system spearheaded by a group of developers. But you see, our principle accords the Chinese principles of stability. And it also follows the model of BTC, of Bitcoin. And avoids negative consequences. Now, what is the third advantage of Ethereum Classic? focus on the future, and not just the past, of the present. Ethereum Classic is in fact not an enemy of Ethereum Core. The reality is Ethereum Classic has become an enemy of Bitcoin. There are people that are abandoning Bitcoin in order to buy into Ethereum Classic. Ethereum Core has never gotten this advantage before. But you see, people have recognized the value of smart contracts. People have realized that smart contracts are a good solution to human problems. You see, what has been observed is that plastic, when it drops in price, large numbers of people rush to buy it. This is the opposite of many other currencies. Other currencies, the price collapses, it triggers a panic and people try to keep running away. But it shows that people recognize that that in Ethereum Classic there is an intrinsic value. So now we're going to talk about the battle with the head. And the first, of course, is a kind of bomb. It's a difficulty bomb. The second is consumption of ETC. Now, whatever we call this, the difficulty bomb, the difficulty twist, this is the code behind the difficulty bomb. Even those that don't understand programming would probably understand it. Period count refers to a period of 10,000 blocks. This is like the parable of the chessboard, where you place one piece of rice in one cell of a chessboard, two pieces of rice in the other. But by the time you get to the end of the chessboard, there will be an exponential increase. So Vitalik has explained if Ethereum Classic didn't exist, only Ethereum Core, as a result, there would be an increase in the delay of the block. Instead of 14 seconds per block, there would be 16 seconds.
Yeah.
At 4.6 million blocks, there will be a giant jump in the difficulty, and that will be roughly September of 2017. This is just an estimate. However, the block time depends on the price. This is just an estimate. This may not be very accurate. But from the point of view of safety, we should be solving this problem as early as possible, because if we miscalculate, it will be difficult. The yellow represents risk. At 4.3 million blocks, there will be substantial risk already, noticeable. A strain upon people. So this problem, from the point of view of development, you don't need to worry too much. But for those that are money, this is a diversity of large proportion. The price might be 10% of the previous price in a crisis. So we need to quickly find a solution for this problem. We want the users of currency in the future to feel safe.